Hello, I'm Graham. In today's video, I want to discuss video lighting. We probably all suffered from the lack of light when trying to produce our videos, and that exhibits itself as lots of noise on our video. The smaller compact cameras tend to be worse for this because of the small sensor size. This video is being taken with the FZ100, and for illumination, I'm using a 500 watt linear tungsten halogen lamp, the type you'd probably find in your home security lamps. It provides quite a high level of lighting, and it's giving me 2600 lumens. So that's quite an intense light, and the camera should be working quite well with that. But the disadvantage of using the halogen lamp is, first of all, it's 500 watts, and secondly, it's quite hot. It produces quite a harsh light as well, and you can see there's quite a severe shadow behind me. So I wanted to find an alternative that would match the light output from the 500 watt tungsten halogen lamp, yet be manageable from a power point of view and from a heat. I started to explore some of the commercial options available to us, but they are very expensive, and being low budget filmmakers as we are, too expensive for our needs. So I started to look at what was available in the fluorescent tube market to see what might be suitable for making into a lighting rig. When we think about fluorescent tubes, we either think about the 6-foot tubes we have in our house or these new low energy bulbs, the double spiral type. These give the equivalent of about 100 watt light and tend to be of the 2700 Kelvin range, so they're quite a warm light. But they don't give enough light for video. So did a bit of research and I come across these fluorescent lamps, and they are big boys. These are called green lamp. It's the YPZ-DS-105 watt. It's rated for 220-240 volts, but the nice thing about this is it's 5500 Kelvin, which is daylight, so it's not going to be warm and it's not going to be cold, so hopefully it's going to be a nice color temperature. It's quite a big unit, and it's got the E27 Edison screw fitting on the bottom. So it was how to mount this and how to get the best light from it. So I started to experiment with some reflector designs, and the one I've got at the moment is the one that I'll show in the picture, and is working quite well. So I'm going to switch over from linear tungsten halogen light to the light from this, and I'll rebalance the camera to give white balance based on this light. And you can see the resulting lux level from this light and the light quality itself. So the scene is now being illuminated with the lighting rig I just designed and built around the 105 watt fluorescent fitting. It's quoted to be the equivalent to a 500 watt tungsten halogen light, but in my measurement here we are only seeing 1100 lux, which is less than half the output from the 500 watt linear tungsten halogen light. Whether that's a function of the reflector design that I've got, I'll have to do some more experimentation, but I don't think we can increase the light level that much more than we've got currently. So the lux being half it was, I've had to up the ISO to 200 on the camera to give an equivalent lighting scene. So the actual overall lighting is less than the tungsten halogen light, but the actual light itself is softer. The shadow behind me is less distinct than when we use the tungsten halogen light. As far as the colour rendering goes, we'll have to look at that on the timeline, but it doesn't look that bad now as I've balanced it with a white card. So that's the end of the review of this 105 watt fluorescent lighting fitting. It has got some potential, but with some more work I might be able to get the reflector design to give more light output. Okay, so this is Graham saying bye for now, and as usual, please rate, comment and subscribe.